you watching us from, welcome to Assam Live. This is Assam Sports on this bright, beautiful, sunny Sunday, special Sunday edition of Assam Sports, where the conversation headed into the weekend, lots of games, exhilarating, blistering, action-packed games, but the conversation was centered around Manchester United and the future of Erik ten Hag after a deplorable, unconvincing, underwhelming start to the season. Erik ten Hag seems to always get a result when his back is pushed against the wall. A game at FC Porto Stadio de Dragao ended in a 3-3 draw. Today in the Premier League, Manchester United against Aston Villa has also ended in a 0-0 draw, giving Erik ten Hag a bit of a timeline, a bit of breathing space. One could call it a grace period. But if you look at the exhibition on the field, it was more of Aston Villa was poor, more than Manchester United being brilliant. The master substitute, Duran, came on similar to regular fashion, but he was still not able to affect the game as he's been able to do in their past games, coming off a 1-0 gargantuan victory over Giants Bayern Munich. Everybody's expectation was that Aston Villa would batter Manchester United, but once again the chatter is that Erik ten Hag seems to always find an adequate amount of results when it matters most. But is that going to be able to sustain a club as big as Manchester United, where a draw in today's world, a draw for Manchester United at Aston Villa sounds more like a victory than a loss? It tells you how much the standards have fallen. The players on the field, once again, Marcus Rashford was substituted to the surprise of many. Anthony came on, Zexi came on, nothing. So in as much as you want to talk about Erik ten Hag's lack of strategy and technical astuity, you cannot fail to acknowledge the lack of excellence from any of these Manchester United players. Janato is inconsistent. Casemiro is nearing his end. Kwabi Mainoo, like I said, if a kid as young as Kwabi Mainoo is the only bright spot in your team, then you know there's a problem somewhere. A problem way bigger than the coach. So heading into the international break, the conversation was if Erik ten Hag lost both games, he will be fired. He managed to get two draws. A draw is still not a win. And is that going to be enough to keep him in the job? What is the plan of this ENEOS consortium? Sir Jim Ratcliffe, a part owner, he is not the outright decision maker, but in an interview he had, he made certain pronouncements that alluded to the fact that his confidence in Erik ten Hag is dwindling. Is he going to be the manager come back from international break? Rumor is that Ruud van Nistelrooy, the former Dutch striker, Manchester United player, legend of the game, now a coach with the coaching staff, he has been brought just in case Erik ten Hag leaves, he will take over. Because if we are being 100% honest, there are no managers out there who are queuing in line. There are no coaches out there who are standing in line waiting to coach this job. It is a very big job, but also the cracks within the ceiling, the roof is leaking. And you cannot just block the roof with wood and hope that the leaks will not leak again. It is a very, very, very difficult job. And I don't think no manager, they try to find managers, nobody is waiting in line to coach this job. So Erik ten Hag's exit might not necessarily be the solution to the United problems. Where Harry Maguire and John Evans were the center backs for the team. When you have Harry Maguire and John Evans, no disrespect, professional players have done a lot, but in this modern day game, the speed, the agility, the flexibility that comes with the game, Harry Maguire and Johnny Evans being your center backs should not be something that you have to deal with as a coach. But unfortunately, those are the tools that Erik ten Hag has in his box. And they could have lost this game, I think Marcus Rashford had only one chance in the first half, but it's a draw enough. Thank you for tuning in to Assam Sports. Lots of games went on. Chelsea also played a 1-1 draw at Stamford Bridge with Nottingham Forest. As a Chelsea fan, I have said it. If Cole Palmer is not on top form, the team looks like a different team. And Cole Palmer is not going to be excellent every game for the whole season. He's only human. He's great. I know. He looks like he's not human, but he is human. And today, once again, in all games in the past, when Cole Palmer is not tippy-top, when Cole Palmer is not being a top boy, the Chelsea team looks like they could lose. Nottingham Forest playing with 10 men. Chelsea still couldn't break their defense. And like I've said, towards the end, there were chances upon chances. Like every Chelsea game, they still need an out and out striker. You cannot do it without it. No matter how you slice and dice it, Manchester City is still the team to beat because they have an out and out striker in the name of Erling Haaland, who can bang in the goals out of nothing when the difficulty gets tough. No matter how you slice and you dice it, this Chelsea team is going to be far better with a striker. All of these players, wingers who score goals, are not natural born strikers, so the goals are not going to come every day. Yes, there might be certain games where they play flawless football and banging the goals, especially when you're playing against low-cost teams like, excuse me, I don't want to mention names, but you know, teams at the bottom of the Premier League. Yes, you will look so good. Nicholas Jackson will look like he's Ronaldo. But when you play against top level, and today, Nottingham Forest defense, what a defensive performance they put up. But the chances that Mikhailo Mudryk came on, got some crosses into the net. If there was an out-and-out striker, Joao Felix got a chance at the end. Easy header, headed it away. So, these are the little things that separate the men from the boys. And I tell Chelsea players, Chelsea fans should relax. The team is not there yet. Defensively, I don't even want to talk about it, because I've told you, there's a shortage of strikers in the world, but there's a shortage of world-class defenders. All the good ones have teams already. So the Chelsea defense, I don't want to mention names, but we are going to concede goals. There's no way around it. But if we score more, then we are going to be able to soak in the deficit and just take it on the chin and win games like 4-2, 5-2. Chelsea defense is going to concede goals regardless of who we are playing against. Sanchez, the goalkeeper, made some great saves at the end. Nottingham Forest could have won this game at Stamford Bridge. That is not good enough. And Chelsea still needs an out-and-out striker. But we are projecting towards the right direction in comparison to Manchester United, on the other hand, who looks like a draw is all it takes for Erik ten Hag to keep his job. What do you think about it? Lots of games went on. Man City won. Liverpool, Arsenal flying. There's no surprise there. But I think Man City is still the team to beat, even though Liverpool sits on top. The depth of your squad, the team with the biggest squad goes the farthest. And even though they've lost Rodri and stuff, they still look like a team. Mateo Kovacic was the one who got the goals this weekend. I mean, Fulham could have scored. Traore, Adama Traore missed some chances. But Man City is still the team to beat. Arsenal find it very difficult to beat a low-level Southampton. 2-1 was the final score. Liverpool found difficulties too in their win. I think it was a 1-0 from Diego Jota. So yes, you can slice and dice it however you want, but the traditional striker is what the game is lacking, is what the game needs, and Man City is great. Teams like Manchester United, Arsenal, Chelsea need strikers heading into the international break. What is your evaluation of the Premier League so far? It's been a wonderful Sunday. Tomorrow, we're going to evaluate all the games that went on. Thank you for tuning into Assam Sports on this bright, beautiful, special Sunday. Like you already know, the Forecast 1.0. Assam Music, click the link in the bio. New music, the Forecast 2.0 is loading. What a channel coming soon. Happy Sunday. This is Assam Sports. Over and out.